Let us learn some practical applications of potentiometer. So, comparison of EMF of two cells. Here we will take two primary cells like Daniell cell one and another one is a Lackland cell. We can take. So, comparison of the EMF of that kind of cell using potentiometer. This is one application of potentiometer. So, the circuit diagram will be look like this. Again we have to draw the potentiometer. Here is the rheostat. This is the wire. This is KK rheostat. This is the battery with EMF E. This is the wire AB, which can be 10 meter long. Now the connection should be like this. Here you see the main battery, the positive terminal of the battery is connected with point A. From here this is our, let us say, Lackland cell, and this is our Daniell cell. These having EMF E1 and this one having EMF E2. So see here, the positive terminal of the both battery or cell, here it is connected at this point A. All the positive terminal of the battery should be connected at this point A. Here this is one commutator. When I wish to connect E1, I will keep this knob connected at this point S. When I want to connect E2, then I will keep this knob at this point. Here with a high resistance R, galvanometer should be connected, and this is our jockey J. Now see, this rheostat over here, we use this rheostat to control the current through this wire. Now this is the battery, the voltage should be divided here and on this resistance wire AB. So this acts like a voltage divider also. When current will flow, it will control the current, current will flow through this direction, it will control the current. How? Because here resistance is constant, because I am not changing the whole wire, but I can change the current. As you know, V equals to IR. If I control the current, resistance is constant throughout this wire. So if I control current, if I change current, voltage will automatically get changed. Clear? On this wire. Now closing the switch at this point, E1 cell is brought in the circuit. Now after that, moving this jockey, let us say at this point we are getting null deflection. That is, the galvanometer is showing no deflection. Why it is showing no deflection? Because the opposite point of the galvanometer is in same potential. In that case, no current flows through the galvanometer, because E1, that is the EMF of the cell, and the voltage over here, let us say this voltage is VAJ. So that should be equal to E1. Let us take, this is our equation number 1. To the principle of the potentiometer, we also know that the potential difference across A and J is directly proportional to the length of the wire between A and J. Now if the length is L1, then I can write VAJ is proportional to L1, or VAJ is equals to KL1. K is I rho by A. So K is a constant. You can write E1. If we substitute VAJ, we will get KL1. This is our equation number 2. Again, if we connect the E2 cell by joining this at this point, and if we get the null point at some other point, let us say over here at J dash, then again similarly we can write E2 is equals to that voltage A J dash, which is our equation 3. And if that length is L2, then VAJ dash is proportional to L2. This is the principle of the potentiometer. So again, VAJ dash equals to KL2, where K is rho I by A. So if we substitute AJ dash, we will get E2 equals to KL2. This is our equation number 4. Now dividing equation 2 by 4, what we will get? E1 by E2 is equals to KL1 by KL2. That is nothing but E1 by E2 equals to L1 by L2. So if we can compare the length where we have got by getting the null point in the galvanometer for E1 cell, and again when we connect the cell E2 and we have got the length L2, if we compare these two length, then that is nothing but comparing the EMF of the two cells. If I know one EMF of any cell, let us say E1 is known, then we can find out E2 and vice versa.